Hi guys, this is Dora from Triumph Harder. I really hope that you are safe and sound out there when you are running, you are keeping it safe, and also the distance and other regulations, what we have to do with this COVID going around. And if you are new to the channel, just let me introduce myself. My name is Dora. I'm located in the Netherlands, in Europe. I have this channel for more or less a year. Yeah, time flies. I started in January 2020. I am an amateur age group triathlete, so on this channel you can expect some content about running and triathlon, gear reviews, race recaps, training tips and tricks. So if you're interested and you find it useful, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. It really means a lot. And today I did something which I was really long planning to do, but I never done it. But it was the time to do it. So I purchased the shoe with really limited knowledge what I can expect. It's a company where the motto is no nonsense. Hard work will really pay off. You have to put the work in yourself and the benefits will come. Now, this is really the motto what I can live with. So that's why I was really interested in what they offer, how their products are. And to be honest, because I found this shoe on a UK, so English website, for £25, which is more or less 30-35 US dollar, I was like, okay, if I wouldn't like it, I still cannot go bad. It's a bargain. Of course, it's not a 2020 design. It is a 2017 or 2018 design. I found some controversial information on the web. So it's an older model, but I was like, okay, I'm going for it, I'm going wild, I'm testing this. So that was the point when I purchased the shoe. And the shoe is a company called Salming. And the shoe is the Enroute version 1. What I knew before I purchased the shoe, this is, has a 6mm drop, really a distance running shoe from the company. And it's really providing some natural running benefits. You can see already with the 6mm drop, it will be not a maximalist shoe, so it's going into the minimalist direction, but with still some cushioning there. I did my initial test run, which is usually 10 kilometers, and I will go through my 5 categories: the upper fit, the midsole cushioning, the outsole, the design, and the price value. So let's start with the upper and the fit. Now, this is my major and only issue with this shoe. I purchased my original size, which is 40.5. In this case, it's 40.23, whatever it is. So it's UK 7 and 26mm of the length of the shoe in normal centimeters, which is really my normal size, so there should not be an issue. But, yes, you can guess, there is an issue. It comes really, really, really small. Now, as I mentioned, I was not doing a detailed search, because that was the meaning, that I'm not doing a detailed search before I purchase it. And on the Salming website, it really came out that you should purchase 2 sizes bigger than your usual size, because it is coming small. Yeah, okay. Now, I'm already smarter. But at the time, at that UK website, where I will put the link in the description box below, it was not mentioned. So with this regular size, I'm really on the small side. It's so small that I might not be able to run further with the shoe. So I have to decide what I will do with this. And maybe give from some of my friends or something like this. Because otherwise, it is really a great one. So on a 10 scale, I gave 4 for the shoe, for the upper and the fit, because of the sizing issue. For the rest, I can say that the upper is really done greatly. It's a 3-layer upper, really high build quality. You can see this Evo skeleton here, which is really providing a great lockdown. I put on the runner's knot, but to be honest, it was not needed. Even the heel is really well built, quite massive, really durable. They say that it's a high breeze quality. I wouldn't agree on that. I think it's in the medium. That's why it's also coming out at 4 out of the 10. So, but the build quality is just great. You can even see here there is some additional rubber, which of course putting some additional weight on, but I like it because so many people have really issues at this part of the shoe, getting some holes on the upper, so it's just a bit of additional stability for your toolbox, and it's keeping it in place. Midsole. I haven't found too much information on the net about the midsole, to be honest. It is nothing fancy, I would say it's a general Evo midfoam. No superb energy in return, of course it's also like a 2 years old model, so it was not like all the carbon fiber plates and whatever, so it's really an old school. Still quite good cushioned, you can see the drop is 6 mm, 24 mm stack height in the heel, 18 in the forefoot, and the weight in my size is 220 grams. So it's not bad at all, it's more or less the Adidas SL20 level of the weight. And what you can see here, basically that midsole is a bit designed higher, which is giving a bit of stability. So though it's a natural shoe, it has some light stability features. Here at the mid of the foot, it's less, but at the heel area, it's really a bit of stability. So it's a natural ride, but you can get some support out of this. For the midsole and the cushioning, I gave 5 out of the 10 for this shoe. It can be better, but if you like a distance shoe, where you have a really good ground feel, it's definitely your shoe. Let's go to the outsole, the third category. As I mentioned, I had one run in the shoe, which was not super wet, but you can see some rubber outsole. It's quite nicely built. It's not super much, but I felt secure, not gliding anywhere. So absolutely the outsole, let's give for the outsole 8 out of 10. So it's quite a nice score. I expect really that the outsole will also last for several hundred kilometers. In general, my expectation that the shoe would easily go to 500-600 kilometers. I don't see any issue with really the durability. Also, the midsole foam seems to be okay. It's not super cushioned as mentioned, but it will go to the distance. Let's go for the fourth category, and that's price value standpoint. Now, we already know that we have to order one or two sizes bigger because en route it's really coming in small. So if we know this information, which I didn't know before I did my purchase, if you buy it in the good size, I think the price value standpoint, you cannot get much better. 30 euro. 30 euro for a good quality distance running shoe from a Swedish company. I don't want to say from other companies, which can get also quite cheap. I also had some experience with all the cheap shoes when I started running. I would not recommend to anyone. But with this company, with this quality of shoe, for 30 euro, that's a 10 out of 10. And the last category is basically the design. You can see, I think it's a very simplistic design. No bullshit, no nonsense. Of course, it's black. Somebody doesn't like black. There are some newer models with all the other colors. Personally, sometimes I do like the white, the black, and it's quite handy for the winter coming up, but I also like some colors. For the design, I have given 7 out of 10. This blue color is of course really much my color. I think it's nice, it's not the nicest design, but it's okay, absolutely okay. And you are using it anyway for running, so the design is not the most important category here. You can also see the Swedish flag here, which I really like. I was always keen on Sweden when we learned it in geography in the school. I was like, once I have to live in Sweden, I really love it. I haven't been there yet, but I hope that one day I will go there. Maybe even do the Kalmar Ironman, which is just an awesome Ironman. It's one of the highest on the whole list as well. So let's see that we'll come after the COVID and the lockdown and everything like this. Which will end one day, right? Yeah, it will end. So at the end of my scale, The summing and root came as an average 6.8 out of 10. Yeah, the Nike Pegasus 37 came up at 7.2 at the original initial run test. This is a bit less, but the main reason is for that the sizing. I think that's really the major drawback here. Who would I recommend this shoe for? Yeah, it is coming as a distance runner shoe. I think it's perfect for distance running if you like a good ground feel. If you like more cushioning, then it's for you. I think it's more like an interval run or fartlek run, but not really a distance running shoe. If I would use it going forward, yeah, I'm really not sure because of the sizing, but then I would go for the interval trainings in this one. So this was the review for today about the Salming and Root. I hope you liked it. If you have any question about the shoe, please drop a comment below in the comment box. I would love to hear about this. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and see you in the next video. Bye!